homophobic.
I'm an ally.
No, is this the dancing?
Oh no, this is the dancing.
Why do you do this to her?
Can't watch.
There's talent when you see it.
Oh, I can, and this isn't it.
Oh, no. No!
Well, I've done that before, actually. I've done that before. Oh, that was fun.
Yeah,
I remember that. I remember that. Hit you in that
like,
take.
Every take, it was like, I finished the dance.
The hit
like,
would go.
Bang! Bang!
I'm not like homophobic. I'm an ally.
I'm an ally.
Congratulations.
We thank you for your service.
The face.
The eyes. I remember doing the read-through.
Yeah, I was about to say the same thing.
And, like, when I read it, Imogen wasn't necessarily a character that I, like, could see that way. Mm. And the first time Rhea did it, I was like, oh my God, this is gonna be iconic.
I think we all knew that this would be a meme, at least, because it's just so iconic. It's never been done before. She tries to be an ally, which I love. And we all knew that this would pop off, and it did.
Didn't we recreate the scene on TikTok fashion? It got like 20 million views or something stupid like that.
Oh yeah.
I'm not like homophobic. I'm an ally.
I mean, I think everyone's had a go.
I haven't actually.
Well, that
I think I'm gonna leave that. I think I'm gonna leave that to everyone's imagination.
We'll make it happen.
That's a really iconic scene in the comics, and it's a pretty iconic scene now in the show.
Yeah, it's
my only real memory of it was being a little bit annoyed because I kind of had this dream that, you know, I would look kind of cool like in the rain, and you know, my hair would be very kind of Ryan Gosling-y in The Notebook, and yet it sort of looks like I've got sort of spider legs on my. She's got like three strands of wet hair. It just looks a bit strange.
As an outsider,
wasn't quite as sexy as
can I just aggressively disagree with you not achieving the Ryan Gosling Notebook
look?
Stop
it.
It's true.
I'm going to be squeezing his knee because he's just flirting with me all day.
Whoa.
Thank you, Bash.
Wow.
You don't care about me at all.
Well, it's not like anyone else is going to want to go out with you, is it?
Charlie. I know you like me. Stop it! Charlie, look, I like you, but I'm figuring stuff out. Literally, what more do you want from me? He told you to stop.
It's a pretty sort of incredible way to start the show.
I mean, I want to punch him, and it's my face.
Yeah.
I was gonna tell you something.
Ooh, what was she gonna say?
You've got the wrong team's face paint.
It's Charlie's fault as well.
Why are you leading us on like that?
What is wrong with you guys? That's a really
It's one of my favorites actually of the arc
of season one.
Yeah.
And most people were like, you left us on a cliffhanger with that scene. So yeah. I love that. It was like one of my favorite scenes.
Slapped.
Charlie's my boyfriend. I still like girls, but I like boys too. And me and Charlie, we're going out. And I just wanted you to know.
Oh, baby.
Oh, thank you for telling me. I'm sorry if I ever made you feel like you couldn't tell me that.
That's my favorite scene in the show.
It's so warm as well. Like, every time I watch that, I smile.
Smile and tears in my eyes every time.
It was a really, really lovely scene to make. And I felt that it was a very important scene to make. And I think that coming out is an extraordinarily important moment for, you know, a lot of people, and therefore something that, you know, you want to do justice and you want to get right. I had to watch this scene so many times now that you continue to pick yourself apart, but it's a lovely scene. And Olivia is just amazing in it.
I was confused and surprised and, like, honestly,
I'm having a proper full-on gay crisis.
Iconic.
And it's not that I didn't want to, you know, kiss you. I was just so confused.
The full-on gay crisis is a line that I was so confused about how to play. I had no idea how to say it. It's quite funny, really. It's a really funny line. And I didn't feel like the way that we were playing the scene was very funny.
One thing I remember about this scene is I had the t-shirt I was wearing. I'd been wearing it for the 2 days before on set, and it must have forgotten to be washed. And because Kit had to like nuzzle into my shoulder, I remember like it smelled so bad.
Oh,
and then Kit
yeah.
thought that I just hadn't showered.
It
or
really
hadn't
did. I didn't want to say it, but it did smell
and then
bad.
I was like, to Kosh, I was like, is this t-shirt been washed? And then, like, oh my god, we're so sorry. And then gave me a new one. And I just remember being really quite embarrassed.
It's really quite offensive, the fact that he's walked into Charlie's room with his shoes on, soaking wet. He's just
sat down on the bed.
Sat down on the bed. I mean, he's the real villain of the story.
What are you doing?
There we go.
I really wanted to drop you in. Also, you can see the continuity difference because we only had like a couple pair of shorts.
Yeah.
So the shorts would just go like, you know, there would be wetness to like here and then to here, but no one notices, so that's good.
Until now.
It's good. You know, now we can distract them in season two.
It's a very cute scene.
It's a cute scene.
Gets me every time.
Oh, sweetheart.
Oh, darling.
Oh, darling. The water was quite cold, actually.
I think
the water was cold, but it was more just the thing of sort of getting out and being wet that was really uncomfortable. Mm. But I also just hate wearing jean shorts, and I have to wear a lot of jean shorts on this show. So getting those wet as well was just, it was just a mixture of...
It's like chafing.
...of discomfort. Exactly that, Joe. It was still, it was a lovely experience that day.